But there's a lot of people, as you mentioned, 80% of people that don't have to go to the hospital, that they, their immune system takes care of it. They don't, you know, they don't have a real severe case. But then you start to read about these other long-term effects that are cropping up, like heart palpitations and all sorts of funny stuff.
So there's one study that showed that 60% a month out still had myocarditis or inflammation of heart tissue. That's pretty scary. You know, what are the long-term effects that we're going to see from this pandemic? Because there's millions and millions that are being infected with this virus. And so even if it's just 1% of the people getting something, but we're seeing actually higher than that, that could really change the landscape in terms of what we see out there in terms of disease and population. So it's not this binary thing about they live, they died. It's they live, but they've got, and the term is long haulers, of course, and more people are becoming long haulers, unfortunately. We don't know how long this stuff is going to last, but I've seen studies, one recent study that showed that one rare side effect was psychosis, people actually hearing things and seeing things. It's very rare, but it's certainly something that's well documented in people that have been completely healthy until they came down with the virus.
Wow. I'm certainly more afraid of long-term effects with getting COVID-19 versus getting a mRNA vaccine. Is this autoantibodies like that you mentioned that is a common thing with getting any viral illness? Has that been looked at or studied or linked to this long-term?
So they're looking at this. We saw in kids there was this Kawasaki-like illness that that was occurring. We just don't know if that's similar to what we're seeing. I anticipate that we're going to be doing a lot more research in terms of the immunity and post-immunity as we go.